I had the Dark Age, and that Dark Age went from, I don't know, 89 or something like that, something around 1990 until 1999. 1999, I had my first full-time steady job, had a reliable car, had a good place to live. I was renting, but it was good. Had a girlfriend, friends. Like, I had everything that I needed in life, but I had room for hobbies. So I went down to Toys R Us and I got two things, not on the same day, but like within a very short amount of time. One of the things I got was a remote control truck. I got the best Nico that they had. It was a monster truck. It was four-wheel drive. It was like 7.2 volts, I think. You know, it was just top of the line because I wanted to get into radio control cars because I always wanted to as a kid, but wasn't able to. The other thing I wanted to get back into was Lego because, again, I had like three Lego sets throughout my entire childhood, but I spent so much time looking at those miniature catalogs and getting lost in them. So I bought this, and it wasn't this exact one here, but an identical copy of this in 1999. This set came out in 1997. It's Deep Sea Refuge from the Divers sub-theme. And this is essentially the thing that is responsible for the fact that I am here now, that I have a channel and all that, because this is the object through which my Dark Ages ended. However, I never built it, at least not back then. Back then, I bought it, but I didn't build this. As soon as I got it, as soon as I opened it up, I started making custom builds. Was the very first thing that I couldn't do it according to the instructions. And I don't remember like my mindset or like how I came to that decision or why, or I don't feel like my mock building began at that moment or anything. It was just completely natural. You know, like, okay, we've got these great parts, but I don't want to build that because everybody can build that. And it's they already have a picture of it. I want to make pictures of new things. So I started making actually in 99 at a company called Ask Jeeves, who's the first natural language search company.
I remember that website.
It became ask.com. And I remember when Google first came on the scene and we were like, yeah, that's for like Uber nerds. Like, you have to type in just the text, just keywords. Nobody wants to do that. Look, there's not even anything on the page. Everybody's doing portals these days. Where are your shopping links? You know, where's your email, your free email account that you could sign up for? Google, give me a break. Yeah, that worked out really well for me. But I did start building a Lego city at Ask Jeeves at their, not their original headquarters, which was like a house, but their first corporate headquarters. They had like cubicles, but they were half height. They used half height walls. So along the top of the wall, it was like, you know, 5 inches or so. It was enough space where I could put a little building. So I took parts from this set and then eventually started adding from other sets that I started to buy. That's where my Lego career began. Of course, I then made a terrible decision probably like a year or so later, where I was getting so heavily into Lego and into radio controlled cars after realizing that 4x4 Nico 7.2 volt monster truck was terrible compared to the hobby level stuff. And I dove into that hobby. I made the terrible decision to go down to just one hobby, and I picked the wrong one. Oh, no. But I'm back now. So I've corrected the errors of my ways, but that's how it all began.
What happened with all your RC stuff? Because I have one on my own, but it's cracked like 15 years ago, and then I didn't rebuild it. A Tamiya, a big one, very expensive as well, but then there was one crash, and I thought, oh my goodness, now I'm gone. What happened with all your stuff? Do you still drive on your own, or is it just gone? It's not your hobby anymore.
Yeah, most of that got sold off. I still have a few of them, like my most special ones, because in the RC world, I was all into customizing also. So I've got some wild, you know, hybrids, and I would go into the engineering of changing the suspension geometry, not just using the holes that were already there, but like creating new pieces and milling carbon fiber parts and Delrin to make things in 3D before we had 3D printers and stuff. So I do still have a few of those things, and I also just this year, one of the suggestions that viewers sent in to me when I was, you know, after January 7th was, hey, you should do something for yourself. You should go buy yourself a new RC. And they actually recommended one in particular. It was a small, like a Jeep, you know, a rock crawler, but really, really small. So you don't need a large space. So I got one of those and already ordered some custom parts to start modifying it, but I've not gotten back into driving RCs since. I feel like I should. I want to, but I only have just a few of my old ones, one new one, and yeah, that's it. The rest of the old ones got just sold off, you know.